हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू नागेश कुरजगी ऑर्किड स्कूल चैनल। आई एम श्रीदेवी कनके। आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू एसएसटी सब्जेक्ट ऑफ ग्रेड 4। सो टुडे इन द लास्ट लेसन वी हैव कंप्लीटेड आवर फर्स्ट लेसन, इजंट इट स्टूडेंट्स? यस। सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू कवर अ सेकेंड लेसन, दैट इज फॉरेस्ट ऑफ इंडिया। नाउ फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, व्हेन आई से दिस वर्ड फॉरेस्ट, व्हाट कम्स टू योर माइंड दैट? Yes, students, can anybody guess? Yes, very good. Forest is a very huge place, correct? And what else you are all telling us? Forest? Okay, if you imagine, if forest is not there, what it could be? Yes, you just think of it. Just imagine that if forest is not there, trees are not there, what will happen to? Yes, because trees are very much important. If trees are not there, what the oxygen it gives? So whatever we take oxygen, so that oxygen come from the trees, so that is main important, correct? If trees are there, a forest is there, so many things can be there. Now same thing, so let us we'll go in further, correct students? Come on, first forest. Lesson number 2, Forest of India. What we are going to learn in this lesson, we are going to learn about the importance of forest. Yes students, how much important forest is. So importance we are going to cover in this lesson, and then types of forest, how many types are there and where they occur in India. So where we can find types of forest we will know in this lesson. And the next is the conversation of forest and wildlife. How to preserve our forest and wildlife. Next, what is forest? First of all, a forest is a large area of land covered mainly with trees and other small plants. Yes students, what is forest? A forest is a large area. A forest is a small or big space? Yes, it is. No, of course it is a big place. It is an area of land covered mainly with what it covered? It's covered with an n number of trees and other small plants, big plants. It's all fully covered with the trees. These trees are not planted by humans. Yes students, can we plant a full forest? Yes, no. These trees are not planted. A full forest means what? A full n number of trees, big tall huge trees were there. It can be planted by us? No, but grew naturally in the region. So how it is gradually? If you all plant one at your home, that you can daily you will give water, then all you will grow one plant. But a forest where it is grown by naturally, means students here, by naturally rain will come, that due to that air and everything it will grow naturally in the region. They are called natural vegetation. So what they call? They call as a natural vegetation. Now the kinds of forest or other plants that grow in a forest depend on the climate and soil of the place. The kinds of trees, what we have, we can see a different kinds of trees and other plants that grow in a forest. How it all depends? It all depends on the climate and soil of the place. Yes, in the first lesson we have studied that how soil is very much important. So here these are different kinds of trees, small plants, big plants, it all depends on the climate and soil. Now how much importance is there? Okay, importance of forest. If forest is not there, if forest is there, how much it is useful to us? Let us see here. Forests are useful to us in many ways. How it is useful in many ways? Let us see here. Forests are also an important natural resources. It is also na soil as it is natural resources like that only forest is also an important natural resource. Some of the important products what are they we get from the forest are as follows. So from forest what do we all get? You all know. So let us see here what all are the important products we get from forest. So let us see here. First one is timber. Now timber, which is mainly used for building houses and making furniture. Now this timber is a kind of a tree where it is taken, it is cut out, and how, by where it uses this kind of timber, kind of wood, it is used in making building houses and making furniture like tables, chairs or windows, different kinds of furnitures we can make from which type of wood? Timber wood. And building houses also, wooden houses will be there na? Yes. Now next one is the fire wood, which is used as fuel. See, can you see here students, this is one kind of a tree where this is a wood where we can use as a fuel. Now what is fuel here students? Whereas the tribal people are there in villages, we have they what they use to cook their food and to take warm water. All everything cooking is done on this type of wood. So this type of wood is used as fuel in the villages. Which kind? It is a fire wood. Next is wood pulp, which is used to make paper. Where now this kind of paper wood, whatever is there, the small pieces, how it is while you are at home or writing, you use the books, correct students? Yes, this kind of books or papers where we can manufacture this, all it can be made from the wood only, it is all manufactured and come to papers. Now what did forest woods we give us? Let us give. No, first they give us rubber, gum, cork and resins, which are used to make paint. Now here see students, you all know trees. Yes, if we see we around our surrounding, we can see so many trees are there. Friend, regularly we using this rubber, how it come? A tree, when we take, can you see this white color? From the tree only it is coming out, all juicy it is collected in a bowl. This is a rubber. And where you can see here one more tree, when we scratch or when we cut that tree, a small sticky brownie color will come out from the tree. That is nothing but it is called as a gum. We use gum when you tear a paper, when something happens, what you need gum. Yes, students, you need gum to paste that paper. So that gum, where it comes from the tree only. It all come from the tree, forest. So next one is cork. See, when the tree is there, a very much big tree, upon that a brown color cover will be there, correct students? Yes. So that also used, what for? That is cork they are using it. See, can you see here and one picture over here, that one tree is there where upper part of the tree they are all removing it. From what they will make? From that they make corks. And the next one is the gum. Just now I told you all resin. Whatever when you cutting the trees, that time your thicky brownish color or yellowish color, it will come out from the liquid type. That is nothing but a resin. This all we get from where students? Yes, we all get from the forest. Now, medicines we get from trees such as neem. Yes, whatever herbal like medicines are there, where we get that medicine also? From the forest. Which type of tree? Like neem tree. It is known as in कडुलिंबाचा झाड ओके इन मराठी इज देअर सो इट इज नीम ट्री वेर इट इज एज अ मेडिसिन वी विल दे विल मेक फ्रॉम दॅट नेक्स्ट फॉरेस्ट आर यूजफुल इन अदर वेज टू Now we have seen that forest, we are getting rubber, resin, different type of products from the forest. Now we will see more in other ways how it is useful to us. First one, forest prevent soil erosion and control floods. Not only it giving products to us, it will help, it will prevent from the soil erosion. How students you are telling me, you might be a questioning there, ki how forest will help? Yes, of course, here forest, can you all see here an image here? Big, big trees, huge, huge, tall, tall trees are there. Under that land would be having roots, isn't it? Roots are there, but roots whatever roots are very important, the roots all it will stick to the land when as a heavy wind or a soil whatever the air it will blow from that places but as a it will fall down trees not easily because forest like trees are very huge which it is sticked to the land roots are very hugely it is sticked to the land So it prevents soil erosion due to so lots and so many trees were there. And how it control the floods? As trees are there, so many are there. For water will there, but it will not go. It will stay there only. In this case also, we can control the floods. So forests are very useful to us. Now how trees are also useful to us you can see here trees supply what tree what does give us it gives oxygen to the air yes students now what we are breathing what we need oxygen yes students yes correct we take oxygen and we release carbon dioxide so here how trees are very useful to us these trees it will give oxygen to the woman and women it will give carbon dioxide it is very useful they increase rainfall by keeping the air cool and releasing water vapor in the air now students here due to that heavy forest due to so many trees are there due to that what happens when is the rainfall how it increase the rainfall students by keeping the air cool whatever the air is there the water moisture the water and release water vapor so it will be stay in there so it in the increasing water vapor it is come to a rainfall only there are many communities and tribes who are almost completely dependent on forest fur now how not only forest we are dependent where in jungle like forest so many people are living isn't it what are they tribes a small small villages communities they are also depend on the forest how we will see they are depend for the forest for the fuel fodder water timber minor forest products and leaf litter for manure preparations now this kind we will see here how fuel is there I told you where as a people like in villages or like jungle peoples what are the tribes those people they live in the jungle how we have having here at home gas are there everything advanced here we can find no how they will use this forest products as wood they will use to make prepare food and what else they will prepare and whatever the agriculture they are doing that fodder this is they are using dried grass and timber whatever the forest this timber will go in the forest that they will take kind and the whatever the dried leaves from the forest it fall down so they are used for the littering their religious and social life is woven around the forest in their areas, the religious, the social, all over it is surrounded by them. It is by surrounded in the forest areas only. Forest provide shelter to wild animals. Forest not only provide shelter to the communities or the tribe people, it also give shelter to the wild animals. Forest means you all know different kinds of animals they live. It is a home for the animals, wild animals. So it is a home. Now what type of, we have covered our what is, how much it is important forest. Yes, now come to the types of forest. What are they? The area under forest in India has been decreasing as we cut down trees to claim land for farming. Now what are the forest are there, the type of forest, the area, whatever the forest under forest in India has been decreasing. How it is all decreasing, students? You all know it, because it will, as we are advancing, what we are all doing, the peoples, they are cutting the trees. They are cutting down the trees to claim. For what they are all cutting? To make new buildings, to make to make land for the farming. So day by day it is increasing and then forest became decreasing. All cutting the trees. Less than 1/4 of land. Less than 1/4 of land in India is presently covered with forest. In totally how much land is there? It is now only less than, not only 1/4, it is more than less than 1/4 it is presently covered forest. Why? Because we are all cutting down the trees. There are 5 main types of forest in India. Now how many types are there? 5 types are there. So let us see that. First one, evergreen forest. Second one, deciduous forest. Third one, thorn forest. Fourth one, mountain or coniferous forest. Last one, and the marshy and the tidal forest. These are 5 main types of forest. So let us briefly see. The first one, evergreen forest. In name only it is there, evergreen forest. In name itself it is telling evergreen. It is total green color. So let us see. Lose evergreen trees lose their leaves continuously and not all at once. As you all know, season changes. Yes, that time what happens? Dried leaves, what are the big leaves, it is fallen and a new leaves come, isn't it, students? Like that. But here evergreen trees are there, that whatever the tree is there, evergreen forest, it not only at a time it will not fall one by one, as now new leaves come, new leaves replace the leaves that become old and fall. As one leaf is there, it will become old and will fall down. In that place a new leaf will come out, as in the same this cycle process going on. Okay, student? And not only at one time it will not shed there all the leaves. One. As one leaf will become old and it will fall down, and in that place new leaves coming starts. So in this case what happened? The whole forest, it will be in a green color only, students. So trees in this forest remain green throughout the year. In a year also, as the season also changes, but the forest whole year it will look like a green only. For how types of, in that we can see here. Now rosewood, ebony and mahogany are some evergreen trees. These are the example of the trees. Evergreen forests are found in warm areas with plenty of rainfall. This type of evergreen forest, where we can find these? We can find in the warm, where hot areas are there with plenty of rainfall or plenty of water. Where water is there, this type kind evergreen forest will be there. And which climate? Warm climate. In India, they are found on the slopes, of the western ghats and in the north eastern states of India. So warm place and plenty of rainfall should be there. So where it will be? At the side of slopes of western ghats and in the north eastern states of India. These places we can find our evergreen forest. What they will need? They need a plenty of rainfall. And which type of climate it needs? It needs warmer climate. Now, such as, what are the states? Such as Assam, Arunachal Pradesh, Meghalaya and Tripura. These are the places we can find evergreen forest. Now come to the point of deciduous forest. Now can you see here in the previous evergreen forest how it is? It is all in green in color. Now come to the point of deciduous forest. Okay, what can you see here? What you will compare it here? Can you see it is, can it look green? No. Some it is yellowish color, some is green in color, some different types are there. So we'll see it what is deciduous forest. Trees in this forest shed all their leaves for some time during the dry and hot summer season in warmer climates. Now what here the deciduous forest, in this forest how what happened, and for some time it will, all the leaves will fall down. It all the leaves will shed their leaves. In which season they'll shed the leaves? In hot summer season. And what is the type of climate? Is like a warmer climate, summer season. That season, what happens? Deciduous forest, all it will is fall down. The tree remain like that only. And as the season changes, winter in cold climates when there is scarcity of water. When water is not there in summer season, water evaporates. We also shortage for water. So there is no water, that time it will always shed their leaves at for some time. What are the examples of deciduous forest are? Deciduous trees are teak tree, sal tree and shisham tree. These are the trees type where we can find in the deciduous forest. Okay students, now can you all tell me now students, deciduous forest how it is look? It is for some time it will all shed their leaves. In this season, summer season, warmer climate, and in winter and in cold climates when there is a scarcity of water. Deciduous forests are also called as monsoon forest. Now this type of forest, what it is, we can call it as also monsoon forest. Deciduous forests are found in most areas of the southern plateau and in the foothills of the Himalayas, where we can find this kind of forest in the areas such as southern plateau and in the foothills of the Himalayas. Now come to the point of thorn forest. Now can you see in the name itself they are telling like thorn. Thorn means what? It is all, when as any rose you all take it, that time what we having? Yes, we having thorns now. Yes, so thorn forest we are seeing here. In the image also I am showing here, see what you can see, sharp pointed, yes, on there we can see, yes, thorns are there. In this forest, these forests are found in areas with very little rainfall. In this, where this thorn forest we can find where there is no water, like Rajasthan, yes. This kind of forest we can see in that places where Rajasthan, like that Gujarat places, where we can have very little rainfall, where is desert place. Short and thorny trees, shrubs grow in such as thicker and double tree. and thorny shrubs grow in such forest. Like these kind of places, what kind of trees can be grown here? Like kikar tree, bubble tree and small thorny shrubs. These kind of trees can be grown in such forest. Now come to the point of thorn. Thorn forests are mainly found in Rajasthan, where we can find, just now I told you all, we can find in the Rajasthan and in the some parts of the Deccan Plateau. Where these places we having a very little rainfall. This kind of places we can find thorn plants or thorn trees. What are there? Can you give example? Yes, very good. Chikar tree, bubble tree, thorny shrubs. So one of the example here it is there, kikar tree, and where we can see here bubble tree. We can see a huge see, leaves are very short. We can see a big thorns. Now come to the point of mountain or coniferous forest. These forests are mostly covered with tall and cone shaped trees with needle shaped leaves. Mountain or coniferous, this mountain type of forest or coniferous, we can call it as coniferous forest also. This kind of mostly covered with how? In this forest, the trees are very huge. Like it is very tall trees are there, and how it is in the shape of cone, ice cream cone type. Yes, with needle shaped leaves, with leaves also in the shape of needle. Examples are fir, pine, spruce, deodar and oak. Once again, examples are fir tree, pine tree, spruce, deodar and oak. These are the example of the mountain or coniferous forest. Coniferous forests are found in the Himalayan region. Now this kind of trees or mountainous or coniferous forest, where we can find? We can find in the Himalayan region. Now students, this is end of a part 1. In the next episode, we will continue with this lesson. Now dear students, now completed half of the lesson. What you need to do, your homework is, you have to read the lesson once or twice and underline the new words. Like we have come to new words, like how many types of forest are there, isn't it? Mountain forest, as a coniferous forest are there, deciduous forest are there, evergreen forest are there. So you all go through the lesson and what are the new words are there, write in a rough book. Okay students, till then, bye-bye.